How much would you sacrifice to be freed of fate's shackles? Would you give your tongue, your hand, your sight?
I would give all that and more.
It is done.
The sacrifice has been made. Whosoever drinks of the mead, the World Tree will remember them.
And you, what is your sacrifice?
My liberty. Suttungr and Gunnlóðr will not forgive this trespass. They will hunt me now to the edges of the Nine Worlds.
What are they to you?
We ruled together for a time. A noble triad, as father, mother, and the sacred voice. 6 times we tried to blunt the fangs of Ragnarok, and 6 times we failed. The mead was our 7th. But they feared how it might change the humans for the worse, so they locked it away and banished me from Utgardr. By your efforts, you have returned to me what is mine. The ashes of my husband. He made his own sacrifice for knowledge. With a few changes to this mead, I may undo old sorrows.
Do as you will. I've had my fill of this cursed realm.
Bright mind, heart's ease. Beloved, I will not fail you again.
Come. Settle your mind, and tell me what you have seen.
Strange things, Valka. I'm learning much and seeing more than my mind can understand.
Go on.
In Jotunheim, I sought and found a mead of incredible power. It promised me a strange effect. To drink it would deliver me from death, shield me from the destruction of Ragnarok. By this mead, I hope to live beyond my own death, well into the future.
Fascinating. Was that your final vision?
They have not ended, not yet. Something compels me to return to Asgard.
The elixir is ready when you are.
The Nornir told me you'd be here. The cord is forged. Gleipnir, I call it. I'll wager there's a good story behind that wound.
A tale for another time. Thank you for this.
When you bind the beast, spare no loose ends. The cord will stretch or shrink to fit your needs.
How tightly will it hold? The beast may resist.
The more you tighten the cord, the stronger it will hold and the greater it will hurt, till the beast is rooted to the ground.
Thank you, Ivaldi. You may go.
You mean from Asgard, do you not? My debt to you is paid in full?
Yes, as promised.
Thank you, Harvey. I did not expect you to remember.
Where will you go next?
Under the mountains of Svartalfheim. Our mountains. To free the Earth's riches. For this is what I know best.
Javi, you're a balm to my eyes. What happened to yours?
A sacrifice for something greater. Is the wolf nearby?
Yes, but he's grown. I have kept him company, but he's consumed by a sadness I cannot understand.
Regrettable, but necessary. I knew from the start this wolf brought ill tidings.
From the start it was a kind creature. But our mistrust and cruelty have robbed the poor wolf of its sweetness and life.
Would it be a kindness to kill it, then?
We are past the time for such mercy. This wolf has power now that would test our strengths combined. I fear he is possessed of a power that renders him ever living.
Then we will offer him a different fate. This cord is unbreakable. You must convince him to wear it. It will act as a leash, whose magic will signal that he is safely secured. An assurance to the Aesir who fear him. A beacon, that is all. No harm will befall the poor Fenrir.
Fenrir, yes. You know the creature's name. Did Loki tell you?
He did. It is a fine name.
Yes. Dweller of the Fens. An apt name for his current fate.
Fenrir! A good word has come!
Leave me.
I wish you well, Great Wolf. But a fear still hangs over Asgard. The Aesir worry about your growing size and strength.
Ready now. And what do they have to be afraid of, old friend?
Javi brings a collar fashioned by the dwarves. A beacon that we may track from a distance to know where you roam. Wear this, and you may live and thrive in Asgard without worry.
I smell something sour.
Wear the collar! I'll return to Jotunheimr. There's no third way.
Son of Loki, have I not treated you with kindness? We are bonded, you and I. And as I trust my king, so you may trust me. Open your mouth. As a pledge of faith, you may take my hand if I am untrue.
Fair.
Be swift, Javi.
It burns!
Javi?
Lies.
Unbind him!
Here you stay, Fen Dweller!
I could not strike the killing blow. All my oaths remain unbroken.
Anyone lesser would have succumbed to his hatred.
If I could have done this any other way...
There was no other way, Javi. Our fates are fixed.
Fate or no, you made a great sacrifice on my behalf.
It was not for you.
Do not think your kindness has made you a new friend, Lord of Imbeciles. I will kill you, all of you, gorging on Aesir flesh.
You may strike the final blow, son of Loki. But I will savor my years of freedom before we meet again. Come, old friend. The healing hands of Freya can help you.
Eivor, you have awakened. With more to share, I hope.
I returned to Asgard.
And what did you see?
I bound the wolf Fenrir, Loki's son, with an unbreakable cord. The beast was enraged by my actions. We fought, and I prevailed, but I could not kill the beast.
You visit lore and legend. Things I would never have imagined to be real. Parables, yet here you live them as memories.
Every moment there was as tactile and as vital as you and I seated in this hut.
This is wonderful.
I betrayed my friend Tyr. I stood by as the great wolf mauled him, tearing his arm off at the joint. I could have said something to prevent it, given him a warning. But I did nothing.
How did it feel?
I was unmoved by his pain. Not hateful, but I did not regret my indifference. A swig of poison that drinks like wine.
Selfishness unmeasured often feels this way.
I can make sense of no more.
I see. The thrust of these visions seem clear to me. As in your first reverie, a fear of betrayal hangs upon you. Odin has seen fit to gift you with his infinite knowledge and the treasure of his experience. Perhaps his tale is a warning. The indifference he felt is a great pity. See that you do not follow this same road. To do so would risk a loneliness, a personal exile, worse than death.
I understand. Or I hope I do. Thank you, Valka.
There's music and there's laughter. I don't know if I'm scared of dying, but I'm scared of living too fast, too slow. Regret, remorse, hold on. No, no, I gotta go. There's no starting over, no new beginnings. Time raises on. Just gotta keep on keeping on. Gotta keep on going, looking straight out on the road. Can't worry about what's behind you, what's coming for you further up the road. Try not to hold on to what is gone. I try to do right what is wrong. I try to keep on keeping on. Yeah, I just keep on keeping on. I hear a voice call, calling out for me. These shackles I made in an attempt to be free.
Branches soothe me, and may all thoughts of chaos fade.
Hurry! We are nearly there.
Peace, Frigg. It will do us no good to arrive at our enemy's doorstep exhausted.
Suttr has our son. Fair Baldur fallen to treachery. Does that mean anything to you?
It does, and Suttr will pay a heavy price for it. We do not serve our cause by reckless haste. The tyrant of Muspelheim acts with purpose, and I would know the web he weaves before I'm caught in it.
So speaks one who never nursed our babe at the breast, nor held him as he slept. You were warming your wife's bed while I nurtured your son.
You were only too keen to send him to my care, and Freya's, when the call of adventure became too great to resist. Now dampen your heart fire. Captive he may be, but there's nothing in the Nine Realms that can harm Baldur.
There is one thing. Pick up your heels.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
my son, demon.
He waits at my master's pleasure. There!
Balder!
Oh, Harvey. You came. As I knew you must. It's been too long since you and I crossed blades.
Then let's make this the final.
To die today.
And so it begins.
Fated to die today.
Disturbing thoughts invade my rest. Merely a dream. Or something more.
The air hangs heavy around you, Eivor. You are troubled.
I had another dream. A vision, like the last. This one full of fire.
Tell me.
I saw the god, Baldr, broken and beaten, held captive by Suter. I tried to save him, but I was defeated and left to die in a pit of corpses. When I awoke, I found this in the fold of my clothing.
Baldr also dreamt of his own death.
This tale I know. Afterwards, his mother Thrík visited everything, living or dead, and had them swear not to harm him.
But she overlooked the mistletoe bush.
And so fate had its way.
Not all visions are premonitions, Eivor. But all hide wisdom, if we have the wit to see it. Drink this, if you would know more. Then go to the sacred circle behind my hut. There is more mistletoe there. Lay the mistletoe around the circle, Light it, and stand within. We shall see what your dream has to teach you.
Valka! What is the meaning of this? Is this some part of your ritual? The flames draw ever closer! Ah! Valka! Would you burn me alive?
If you would reach your dreams, Eivor, you must not run from the fire. You must become it.
He's not well.
A passing weakness. It's nothing. We should continue.
Are you sure? We could rest a while.
They kidnapped my son, murdered his mother. I will not rest till I repay these wrongs.
Oh, forgive me. You lifted me from that fly-blown hell, set me on my feet again. You do not deserve my rage.
And you do not belong among the dead. Not yet. Now come on, your gift awaits. Take it, Lord of Asgard. Put it on. From the dwarves of Svartalfheim, to you.
This is a mighty gift indeed.
Told you they'd like it.
Sinmara.
I thought I heard the mewing of an Aesir kitten. My husband should have stamped on you when he had the chance. But mercy is no flaw of mine.
I will see red vengeance on all of you for what you have done.
And I will enjoy watching you fail. You fight well. Better than your woman, at least.
Come at me, then! Let's finish this!
Oh, I'll be back. I will hunt you to the far corners of the Nine Worlds. Treasure every moment, Havi. For death is at your heels. And you know not the hour it will find you!
Shinmara! Damn you to hell!
You beat Sinmara! I never dreamed I'd see it! Fate has truly sent us a hero!
Fate bends to my will. Now, show me to this shelter of yours.
The sign they left us spoke of a hidden path. Look around in the woods. That will set us on our way.
Sigrun and Hallstein! Well, slap my bollocks and call me an elf. You found us! And with all those Muspels on our doorstep.
You know about the Muspels?
Wouldn't be much of a chief if I didn't. Hope you didn't wear yourself out coming out to warn us.
Actually, we kinda did.
And who's this you've got with you?
I am Havi, called Wolf's Bane, Raven Guard, the High One of Asgard.
That right. They call me Brood. Arse-scratcher, snot-snorter, he of the crusty toe.
Havi is here because we have an enemy in common. Surtr has taken his son captive.
He fought Sinmara to a standstill. I saw it!
Surtr, eh? Any enemy of that oversized stack of hearth sweepings is a friend of mine. Come inside. You two, get some rest.
Wait, Javi. Before you go, I have another gift. We would not have made it here without you.
Nor I without you, my friends. I'd say we're even.
Take this all the same. It's silica. Bring it to a blacksmith and they will put it to good use on your behalf.
Thank you, Sigrun. And you, Halsteinn. May our paths cross again soon.
Salutations, Chief. Who's your friend here?
They've got too many names to remember. All you need to know is they've got silica.
And a bracer of such craftsmanship as makes my hammer arm weep with envy. That's a fine thing indeed. But maybe not so fine that it can't be enhanced somewhat. Any half-decent blacksmith should be able to help you improve it. Assuming you have the right materials, of course.
Others here will be glad of a stranger's silver. Look around a while, if you like.
You know my purpose. I have no time to tarry here.
He asks for death who goes to battle unprepared.
One thing puzzles me. You cower in these holes like rabbits. Why not fight back?
We fought at first. Fought hard. But they hit our leaders. Scattered us. Once they divided us, we were done.
Then join together. Raise your axes and throw them off.
That simple, eh? Look. We don't even know where the others are. The shelters were planned so that if one of us was caught, we couldn't give them all away. But you could find them, I'd wager.
My business is the Sutr and rescuing my son.
You might have noticed that Sutr can't be killed. Could be a problem.
I will find a way. Or else I will seize what he values most and trade it for Baldur's freedom.
Either way, you'll need our aid. You don't know an inch of this land. Listen, Javi. I understand. This isn't your war. You just want your son back. But those Muspels on our doorstep, they ain't no joke. If they find us, we're dead meat. Thing about Muspels, though, is they love to fight amongst themselves. All that's stopping them is fear of Sutr. Take out their leader. They'll tear themselves apart. Flee back to Muspelheim, most likely.
And Svartalfheim will once again belong to the dwarves.
Dwarves who will be very, very grateful to the one who delivered them. There's more gifts where that bracer came from.
I make you no promise, but I will seek out your shelters. Perhaps there I will find the means to save Baldur.
Good enough for now.
I am Javi. Lord of Asgard.
You. You're a long way from home. Or are the Æsir now invading us as well, jailer of Ivaldi?
Ivaldi owes me his freedom. Where is he? I would speak with him.
Be my guest. I assume you know the way to Helheim.
He's dead. How?
How else? Or do you need both eyes to see the Muspels everywhere? That was uncalled for. I... Walk with me. I am Gundborg, leader of this shelter. Or what remains of it now Ivaldi is gone. He was trying to make contact with the other shelters. There was an ambush, Glott's soldiers, and something else. Something worse. A creature of fire and fury. It devoured Ivaldi home.
No doubt Brett in Surtur's dungeons. Perhaps with Loki's aid, before I could make him my captive.
You and your captives. Regardless, Uldar fell soon after Ivaldi did. Our mines and miners. Any survivors now serve Glott.
Is that name meant to mean anything to me?
Glott is Surtur's bastard son. Half Muspel, half Jotun. A nightmarish being. Capable of tearing a dwarf in two.
It takes little effort to do so.
You mock my kind?
I saw it with my own eyes. I still see it when I try to sleep.
I spoke out of turn. And yet, Glad has not simply slaughtered your people. He needs your miners. To what end?
The invaders hunger for secrets buried deep in the ground. Ancient relics. The Muspels place great importance in them.
And how do you know this?
Enough, Javi. We have suffered enough. Now I must endure all these questions.
Aid me with your knowledge, and I shall strike a blow against Glad and all Muspels.
In Ullor, we had someone gathering information for us. The miner, Frithjofr. He's been silent for days now, which is unlike him. Probably dead for all I know.
Anything sought by the Muspels must be mine. Where was Frithjofr last seen? Perhaps I can find him.
There is a house in Ullor. Its owners killed by Muspels long ago. There we would exchange messages with him.
This house? How do I find it?
It's the tallest house in the Jeweler's District, by the city's south gate. Just look for the gold in the streets. You'll see.
Frithjofr may be the key to obtaining these relics Suthra seeks. What happened here? The artisans who once worked here. Their life's work. How trivial these trinkets must seem now, given all that has happened. Jewelry for every occasion. This building surely played host to important moments in the lives of many. And look at it now. Someone was beaten. Tortured, perhaps. Then dragged along the ground here. No, you cannot be Frithjofr. But you know of him. Then, are you Tira?
Tira! Yeah! Tira! Gadwi mas an amindach yidhaba! Tira! Frithjofr!
Do you even know where he is?
Frithjofr! Yeah! Frithjofr! Tira!
Wait! Wait! Do you understand me?
We do not know any maru or saros anymore.
Tira? Oh, thank the stars you're safe. I'm all right, I'm all right. You know, all things considered. This one got you out, too.
Enough prattle. Where is the relic?
Not one for small talk, are you?
Isn't that everything a dwarf says?
Ha ha ha! Not bad. Just keep your breeches on, yeah? That relic I found? The Muspels have it. Took it to the palace, I'd wager.
And what is it?
Damned if I know. Moment I yanked it free from the ground, there was a blast of bright white light, and that was the last thing I saw.
That's not what I asked. What does it do?
Other than blind unsuspecting dwarves? Dunno. Muspels didn't seem sure either. Hence taking it to that bastard scholar up in the palace.
This palace. A Muspel stronghold, I take it.
You're a sharp one. Ivaldi was commissioned there, long ago. Einar's there now. Piece of shit. He's the one who'll have your relic.
Einar? Beti sonam, Einar?
He's a traitor. A dwarf working for the Muspels. So don't you believe a word he tells you. You get a chance, you kill him.
I shall judge who lives and dies. Where is this palace?
If we're still by the dig site, you can probably see it. to the south. Modest little place, sitting atop a great bloody rock.
Modest little place indeed. Very well, I shall take this relic for myself. What will you do now?
What's it to you, whatever your name is?
If I find you have lied to the Lord of Asgard, I will want words with you.
You? You're? Oh my days. Well, look, I got nothing to hide. We'll make for the shelter. Go see Gunborg.
Very well. If you're true to your word, then we shan't need cross paths again.
Failed me for the last time.
You don't understand!
Now it lies dormant, useless. The only means to awaken it.
I've searched everywhere, but of all these records are a mess. Rest assured, I will... The purpose of...
The only purpose it has served is drawing out vermin!
Tell me, where did the son of Sutr take that relic?
I can't! Just... look! Who are you?
I am Harvey of Asgard. I hold your fate in my hands. Answer me before the room is swarmed and I leave you to the Muspels.
No! I can help you! You saw through the portal Glord opened, yes? You saw the vault? I can get you inside. I can!
I'm listening. Best you are swift.
The vault, it's sealed with an ancient magic, but I can get you inside.
You can help me get the relic?
Yes, but that is not the prize. It is what happens within the vault that can truly shape our fates.
They will be upon us soon. Can you walk?
I don't think so.
Very well. I need answers, now, traitor.
Do not call me that! I had my reasons! Not that you'd understand such an abstract concept as reason, you mad, spiteful, half-blind!
Choose your next words carefully. They may be your last.
They have my boy. The Muspels. I only did what I did to save him, you see. You save him, I'll do anything you ask. I'll damn well walk you into Glod's vault myself.
Stop!
My boy. Oh, my boy. What have they done to you?
Get off me.
She wanted your life spared, not me. You backstabbing stack of shit!
Silence! Balder would never dare speak to me in such a way. You've lost your eyes. You want to lose your tongue as well? Three dwarves is three more than I planned on rescuing. Can any of you fight? Of course not. So I must find other uses for you. You owe me.
We have much to discuss, but we need to get this one into the Vault of the Ancients.
Are you... Do you have any idea what you're saying? To do that, you'd need...
A sunstone, yes. And very precisely augmented. Lad, if this is what it takes to drive out the Moosepels...
Then it must be done. All right.
There is a sunstone that watches over Ornarthorpe. Bring it to me, at Vergemir Milna, and I shall forge that which we need.
Must I do everything? Very well.
I was starting to worry you may have met with resistance.
Those who resist me are not long for this world.
Indeed. And we are not short of foes in this area, so I'd be glad for your company. Come, my workshop is close.
Here, Einar, your sunstone.
This is where you worked before the Moosepels invaded.
One sight of many, indeed. When the Moosepels took Uldar, captured Frithjofr, and my niece.
Tira.
Yes. I returned to the city, worked with the Sons of Ivaldi, but to no avail. So I allowed myself to be captured. Offered my services to Glott.
To rescue your son. There's more to you than meets the eye, Master Einar.
As you can see, it's been some time since I was last here. Now, if I may ask, what does the High One of Asgard seek in Svartalfheim?
My motive is not so different to your own. A son to rescue. To do so, I believe I need the relic. Though to what end remains a mystery.
I see. So you're not here to save dwarf kind.
If butchering Moosepels in my path aids your cause, then I will not deny you my gifts.
You are most generous.
It has been said, yes.
Damn it all to Helheim!
What? What is it?
Do you fail me, Einar?
The Sunstone must endure incredible heat for me to render it into a new form. My instruments are no longer capable. I'm sorry.
Give it to me. I have the means to endure any heat.
Of course. When the process is complete, the Sunstone will shine brightly. Bring it to me then, and I shall finish what you have begun.
Big words from one so small. It will be done.
How did you... I know better than to ask.
Do you have what you need now?
Yes, I believe so. Let me see. Ah! Still hot.
Will this work? Einar.
Sorry. I've only ever read about this in the ancient scriptures. I've never seen it with my own eyes.
Can you get me into the vault or not?
I believe so. But Glott is no fool. He'll surely have made preparations.
Let me worry about Glott.
As you wish. Now, if all has gone to plan, Frithjofr and Tira will be in position by the time you arrive within Uldar's old city, the great cavern at its heart.
And you?
I must catch my breath and calm my nerves, but I will join you there as soon as I can.
See that you don't fail me.
Have I thus far? I'll do as I've promised. The vault will be yours.
What of your eyes? Are they mended?
Getting there. Recovering. Thank the gods.
You're welcome. Now then, show me what to do with this augmented sunstone.
Einar?
Alive, last I saw, but old and slow. We must begin without him.
Now, place the sunstone here. The Vault of the Ancients.
Bloody Anhagoil.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
What is wrong? Why isn't it opening? Is there something wrong with the mechanism?
Yeah, about that. I'd feel a lot more confident if my father was...
Help!
Get to work. I'll stretch my fighting arm.
I'll take point!
Kill the dwarves!
Any idea
what you guys are doing? Burn!
I have the scripture, right?
Bloody lost it!
You may have noticed I was being bloody chased.
It is done.
Took you long enough. By Ymir's armpits, what are you doing here, you one-eyed shitbag?
Seeking a relic. It's somehow grown more wrinkly and ill-tempered since I last saw it.
Fuck off. Looking for this, I'd wager.
The mighty relic!
Piece of junk. I took out all the good stuff already.
What?
Then we shall take our leave.
What do we have here? My stepson takes his mongrel eyes off you for 1 second. And look at this mess. To think his father expects him to rule Muspelheim one day.
Oh no, 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 no. She's one of the bad ones.
She's nothing. But she has Thrieg's blood on her hands, and must be. Find another way out.
The way we got in! Quick!
Get to the shelter. I'll see to her.
Promises, promises.
Give me my son! And I shall torture you only a little.
All I shall give you is death! You're improving, mad one. Almost worth my effort. Your anger makes you clumsy. Did you care for both?
That's right, you mewling quim! Run back to Suther!